Yeah.
Yes.
So, Shravan, your question is, the world is projected by Ajnana. Okay, now where is the data required for this world projection? Okay, and substance required for the world projection. So the substance required for the projection of the world comes from the Sattvaguna, Rajoguna, Tamoguna, which is called Prakriti or Maya. Okay, now the knowledge is required to project the world. The knowledge is required to project the world does not come from Jiva, it comes from the Ishvara. The Ishvara always has the knowledge how to project the world from the microscopic level to macroscopic level, from subatomic level to the galaxy and universe. Every functioning requirement the Ishvara knows. That's why he is called omniscient and omnipotent. Now this Ishvara, where does the Ishvara's knowledge come from? Ishvara's knowledge is eternal. It is there. So to give an example, Jiva, as me or you, we have a memory. We are chitta. In our chitta, our impressions, our vasanas, all those things are stored. In the Ishvara's chitta, Ishvara's memory, the entire creation is there in the information form. So that, I would say, is Vedas. Vedas means knowledge, not just Rigveda, Yajurveda, Samaveda. The totality of creation, what is required, is the Veda. So that is there in the Ishvara's memory, Ishvara's chitta. So now the Ishvara chitta, Ishvara uses that chitta to project the universe. The universe has two aspects, objective reality and subjective reality. See, for example, I and you, see the same world. Now this world is objective reality for both of us. Now the objective reality for both of us does not mean that there is an objective world. There is an objective projection. Because for both of us, the Ishvara is the inner reality. Right? Ishvara sarva bhutanam hrdaye arjuna tishtati. Ishvara is there in the heart of every living being. Because of the consciousness of Ishvara, which is there, we see an objective reality, we see one objective reality. That is called Ishvara Shrishti. And everything in the universe belongs to Ishvara Shrishti, including body, mind and intellect, everything. All panchabhutas. And the entire universe objective reality is Ishvara Shrishti. Then there is something called Jiva Shrishti. Jiva Shrishti is because of Ajnana. Ishvara Shrishti is because of Jnana. Ishvara has never ignorance. So Jiva Shrishti is because of Ajnana. I don't know who am I. So that gives rise to Ahankara and Mamakara. Then Jiva, what it does, it takes a part of the creation as me. The body as me. And has the subjective world, subjective reality, which is separate from the objective reality. So this is called Jiva Shrishti. Okay, now Ishvara Shrishti is the totality and Jiva Shrishti is the individuality. So I can give an example of this in the form of a river and a whirlpool. The river is there, water is there. A whirlpool is formed, a small whirlpool is formed where it has its own properties. So Jiva, ego, with the ego, it forms a whirlpool in the universe, the consciousness. Ishvara Shrishti. Now, with the Atma Jnana, this Ishvara Shrishti will continue. The body will not disappear, the intellect, the panchakoshas of the Jiva will not disappear. The objective world will not disappear because there is Ishvara Shrishti. But what disappears is the I thought, which is Ajnana, Ahankara Vritti and Mamakara, my thought. These will disappear. So body of the Jnani does not fall off, it does not disappear. So in the Ajnani's case, there is a memory. The memory is individual. This memory consists of two components, psychological component and data component. The data component is a chair as a form and name, a table has a form and name. This is a data component. Okay, this table belongs to me, is mine, is a psychological component. In case of Jnani, this data component will continue. The psychological component will go, my chair will go, I am body will go. So now, whatever data is there, whatever information is there, a table will be table, a chair will be table for him. But he has no identification with that in terms of psychological identification. He will say, the table, chair, the body, mind, intellect, panchakoshas, everything belongs to Ishvara. Like that, he will, Ishwar, Jiva Shashti will go and Ishwara Shashti will continue as long as the body is there.
Okay.
And body of a Jnani or body of Ajnani is created by Ishwara. It's not a projection by Jiva. It's a creation by the Ishwara using the raw material of Sattvaguna, Rajoguna, Tamoguna and Prarabdha Karma.
Okay.
Right?
Okay. Good. Okay. So, for the Jnani, everything is just the work of Ishwara, and the five elements and five, all these things, and all the layers of the sattva, rajas, tamo, guna based information, the data, is all there, but not identified by his I thought.
Yeah, there's no private property in case of a Jnani.
Okay.
Right? It's all, I gave example of a communist government. There's nothing called individual private.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, everything belongs to Ishwara. There's the understanding of Jnani.
Yeah.
Okay. So, in case of Ajnani, something belongs to me. There's a constant tussle in the Ajnani between Ishwara and Jiva. Jiva wants to possess more from the Ishwara's property. That's the tussle. In case of Jnani, that struggle is given up. Everything belongs to Ishwara.
Okay. Okay.
Clear?
Okay. But in at the core, both the Jiva as in Jnani and Ajnani and Ishwara are all Brahman.
Yes. So Jiva, when you say Tattvamasi, it is said that Jiva is Ishwara. So that means, that's meaning as Jiva, we have to expand as Jivatma. Jivatma is Jiva plus Atma. Okay, Jivatma is Ishwara. In the sense, Jiva is the ego. Buddhi plus, Buddhi with the ego, identity with the ego is called Jiva. Now Atma is the self. And that self Atma is Paramatma, because there's no limitation. The limitation of the Atma is imposed by the Jiva. I'm the body, I'm the mind, I'm the intellect. When the limitation goes, Atma is Paramatma. Atma, Paramatma is common to both Jiva and Ishwara. Okay?
Okay.
So, at the Paramatma level, Jiva and Ishwara are one.
Okay.
That is the meaning of Tattvamasi. You are Brahman. Right?
Okay. So from that way you are Brahman. Okay.
Okay. Otherwise Jiva with a small body is not Ishwara, because Ishwara is the totality. Right? Jiva and Ishwara are one at the consciousness level, awareness level, which is Brahman.
Yeah. Yes, Prabhuji, this is great. Thanks. This is exactly clears my doubt.
This is what is my limited understanding.
Yeah, your limited is my unlimited. thanks a lot.
Okay, I'll stop this.
There you go.
Oh, one minute. Shravan, I think.